So India has added another gold medal to the tally of Asian Athletics Championship, and we are celebrating another day on April 26, 2019. So good morning, everyone. This is the Morning Tales for April 26, and it's 8 a.m. in the morning. And without wasting any time, let's discuss the important current affairs for April 26, 2019. Recently, RBI has decided to sell its entire stake in which of the following financial institutions? So before discussing about the RBI stake sale, let's discuss about what are the important financial institutions in India. The list of the important financial institutions. So there are major four financial institutions. The first one being NABARD, NHB, SEBI, and the Exim Bank. So these are the four major financial institutions which are regulated by RBI and the Government of India. So there is recently a stake sale by RBI in two financial institutions. They are NABARD and NHB. First thing you need to notice is what is the full form of NABARD and what is the full form of NHB. So you need to mention your answer in the comment section below so that you can recall the full form of both the organizations, that is NABARD and NHB. And not only NABARD and NHB, mention the full form of the Exim Bank and the SEBI as well, the important financial institution. Now coming back to the news where RBI has sold the stake in two organizations, the financial institutions, NABARD and the National Housing Bank. This has been done on the recommendation of the Narasimhan Committee, which was formed in the year 1998 related to the banking reforms. Remember this thing, it is very important. This is the Narasimhan Committee 2 and there was another Narasimhan Committee, which was Committee 1 formed in the year, or they gave the recommendation in their 1998. One. So on the recommendation of the committee 2, the Narasimhan committee 2 and the discussion paper prepared by RBI, that is the harmonizing the role and the operations of development financial institutions and bank, the RBI sold the stake in NABARD and National Housing Bank. If you look at the headquarters, then SEBI has its headquarters in Lucknow, Exim Bank in Mumbai, NABARD has its headquarters in, again in Mumbai, and NHB in New Delhi. Very important to remember these things, and do not forget to mention your answer regarding the full form for all the four financial institutions, that is SEBI, Exim Bank, NABARD, and the National Housing Bank is already mentioned over here. Moving on to the next very important question. What is India's rank on the startup ecosystem ranking for 2019? So this ranking was released by the startup Blink. This was the data released by Startup Blink, and India has ranked at the 17th position. If you know about this information, then well and good. If you don't know about this information, then India was at the 37th position before this ranking, and now it has moved to 17th position, improving up by 20 spots. Talking about the top three countries on the startup ecosystem, then they are United States, United Kingdom, and Canada, where United States is at the first position. It is actually the unchanged position with these three countries in terms of the good startup ecosystem which these countries are providing to their startups. So in this ranking, 100 countries were surveyed, and not only countries, there were more than 1,000 cities which were surveyed for this startup ecosystem ranking. And in terms of the cities, the San Francisco Bay of United States has topped the list. So the country itself is United States, and the city is again from United States, that is San Francisco Bay. If we talk about the parameters which have been used for compiling the startup ecosystem ranking, then the parameters revolve around the amounts of fund which could be raised by the startups, the number of investors which are there for the startups, and the new startups opening, the ideas behind the different startups. Another question for today is, which of the following days observed on April 26th? So for today, the day which is observed is World Intellectual Property Day. That is the World IP Day is observed on April 26th. If we talk about the different days which are mentioned over here in the that is the World Press Freedom Day, World Cancer Day, World Bee Day. So what are the different days on which this is observed? So World Press Freedom Day is observed on May 3rd. The World Intellectual Property Day, that is World IP Day, on April 26th. World Cancer Day on February 4th. And World Bee Day on May 20th. Now, coming back to World Intellectual Property Day, the very important thing regarding the day is which organization observes the World Intellectual Property Day? Which organization observes? You need to mention that in the comment section below so that you get an idea about the different organizations which are observing different important days. What was the theme for the World Intellectual Property Day? So it was Reach for Gold, IP and Sports. As the picture is mentioned over here, that is Reach for Gold, IP and Sports. And even if you don't know about the answer, try and guess the answer in the comment section regarding the World Intellectual Property Organization. Another and a quite interesting question. Which of the following has introduced the first Indian platform for wholesale cryptocurrency trading? So this is for the first time that the platform has been introduced in India where you could trade the cryptocurrency on wholesale basis, and it has been launched by the BuyuCoin, which is among the oldest cryptocurrency exchange in India. The oldest cryptocurrency exchange in India. Now, talking about this first Indian platform for wholesale cryptocurrency, so this is basically the platform where users would be able to trade on the large scale with low price fluctuations. Also, there is one benefit with this free trading model that it charges zero fees for any trade, which is quite a benefit for the traders which are dealing in the wholesale cryptocurrency trading. Now we talk about this BuyuCoin. So this was founded in 2016 as the India's first Bitcoin exchange with the credit card payment facility. So this was for the first time that the Bitcoin exchange was providing the credit card payment facility while you are trading in the cryptocurrency. Moving on to the last information for today. So Asian Athletics Championships 2019 has been concluded. And there are definitely questions from the sports sections regarding these championships being held, whether it's the wrestling championships, the athletics championship or boxing championship or any other championship which is being held around the world. So when we are talking about the conclusion of this Asian Athletics Championship, so the first rank in terms of the medal tally has been taken over by Bahrain, where they have total of 22 medals and 11 are gold. If you talk about India, so India is at the fourth position with 3 golds, 7 silver and 7 bronze medals, totaling up to 17 medals. So India has concluded the Asian Athletics Championship with 17 medals. We have already discussed about the 2 gold medals in the previous videos of Morning Tales. Now we'll be discussing about the another one, that is the PU Chitra. So PU Chitra has won the gold medal in the 1500 meter race, and it was again an exciting race similar to the Gomati Marimuthu who won the 800 meter race, and PU Chitra, she won the 1500 meter race. Another gold medal, the last gold medal, was won by Tejinder Pal Singh Tuwar in the shot put. So these are the important gold medals in the Asian Athletics Championship, and we have already discussed about the destination on which this place in which this Asian Athletics Championship was organized. So it was Doha, Qatar. There is one more championship which is going on, and it's regarding the tennis. So the World Table Tennis Championship is being going on, and it will be concluded on 28th of April. What you need to mention is that where will be this World Table Tennis Championship is to be held. Mention the country in which this World Table Tennis Championship will be concluded or is to be held. Do mention your answer in the comment section below. And if you have learned anything from this video regarding these morning tales, so do not forget to subscribe to our channel Anuj Jindal. Do not forget to press the bell icon as well, as you know that once we post the video on YouTube, you'll be getting the notification only when you press the bell icon. And the bell icon is just next to the subscribe button. Mention your answers in the comment section so that it becomes easier for you to remember the different facts regarding the current affairs. Thank you so much. We'll be meeting at 8 a.m. tomorrow.